How to improve the quality of life of a seriously ill child and the whole family? Who are the coordinators and attendants? How to organize professional palliative care and volunteer work at the European level? In Kharkiv, volunteers and doctors from different regions of Ukraine took training courses which was held by professionals from Germany. A team of three experts held a master class. This is a joint project of the Rotary Club of Kharkiv Nadia and the Rotary Club of Konstanz-Mainau, Germany.
The idea arose after my meeting in Kharkiv with the Honorary Consul of Germany, Ms. Tatiana Gavrish, and during a conversation when we discussed our Rotary project, she asked me, are there any friends who have experience in working with a children's hospice? In Kharkiv there is no such things, and it would be good to organize this. And by chance, and most likely not by accident, I have closely known hospice leaders in the city of Konstanz, and my club Konstanz-Mainau has allocated funds for this project. With these funds, we organize study. The project is supported by Germany from the club Konstanz-Mainau, and from Kharkiv the project is supported by the club Kharkiv Nadia, and the whole group of very active, very fiery people who are very helpful in this project. They are Svetlana Feldman, the president of the club Kharkiv Nadia, and Irina Jumperts, a pediatrician.
Representatives of the hospice center in Konstanz told how the assistant process was actually developed in Germany. 25 years ago, the hospice movement was created on religious principles. Today, everything is built on professionalism, develop infrastructure of volunteers and not only. Medical, psychological assistance is provided to all, regardless of religion. There are no casual people among workers, and each of them had experience of loss. Their slogan is "Somebody sometime needs everyone."
It is very important for us to get the experience of a working hospice to hear the advice of practitioners and specialists and volunteers. To ensure that in our country among those people who want to engage in palliative hospice care to form the right ideas, the right standards and the right roadmap. In this context of volunteer support, it is clear that we do not have failed services, and it's just about how to apply the experience of Germany in Ukrainian realities. Because a failed palliative team is needed, and for many years doctors have been striving for such a team. A lot has been done both by Roman Maraban and Andrei Pinkov to this end, because they understand how important this is, nobody else.
A hospice in Germany is a medical institution where comprehensive medical and social assistance is provided, including pain relief. Basically, there are children with non-oncological chronic diseases, central nervous system damage, genetic diseases, Hurler disease or Hunter syndrome, severe forms of cerebral palsy, and so on. Oncological patients receive care at home or in the clinic.
Of course we need here an understanding of our work. There are a lot of professionals here, although perhaps the infrastructure is not as developed here. My activity began in 1995 in the hospice of the city of Konstanz. At us, this process was enough labor-consuming too. We need people who have a big heart, and their courage is necessary that would be engaged in this activity.
Experts are convinced that everyone can choose that niche, that kind of assistance in which he feels most comfortable. There are volunteers who are ready to help the hospices but do not watch of their emotions. They say they are not yet ready to communicate with their families, but they can help somehow differently. As for the policy of European hospices, it is built on complete trust and openness. If a child asks about the most important, he gets an honest answer, and some traditions may seem too frightening.
I
If we are talking about qualified palliative care in a civilized world and in our country, that only comes to it, that is, it is absolutely mental things. How is it in our understanding? A patient needs to be saved until the last second, to do everything. This is what we were taught. The whole civilized world has already realized that human rights, the person's desire, does not depend on the level of technical capabilities, medicine, the state and everything. If the patient, his near and dear ones, understand that they do not want to prolong at any cost every day of life, it is important for them not just to prolong each day. For them, it is important to feel every day that they have left before going to heaven, every day without pain and suffering. Therefore, this is a completely different paradigm. In the West, it has long been understood that medicine is good, technological things are good, but the patient's rights is holy. The rights of the individual are above all.
In Germany, they do not taboo the topic of going out into another world. On the contrary, they talk a lot about death, including with children. In Ukraine, death is mostly hushed up, especially with children, when the diagnosis is incurable. However, a child understands everything and expects from his family the truth.
Это правда очень важная работа. И то, что приехали наши коллеги из хосписа,
This is really a very important work. The fact that our colleagues from the Germany hospice came from Germany is like a mouthful of water, I believe, for our society. This is a help in organizing a space where the process of death, dying and grief must be realized in our society. If we postpone this topic thought, each of us will face this sooner or later. Then we are not ready, not prepared for when it will come. And the hospice system is exactly the place where this can happen.
Всегда кто-то должен сделать этот первый шаг, и я думаю, что все получится.
Always someone should take the first step. I think we will make it. I realized in Germany, it does not matter what country you are living. It does not matter whether you are rich or poor. When the child is sick, it is equally painful for both parents and other members of society too painful. They try to help. Both of our problems and worries are similar. It seems to me that more people will do good. Even on a minor scale, we will all get better.
Actually, help is needed not only for the patient, because a serious illness traumatizes the whole family. One specialist cannot help a palliative patient. We need a well-coordinated teamwork of doctors and volunteers. Therefore, professional palliative care is the work of the whole team.